This morning, a public school in Ohio receives legal action from a family after surveillance video shows their autistic son being hit by a teacher's aide. Kaplan's news reporter Victoria Fonseca has more on the lawsuit.
So I just feel disrespected, like they just don't care.
It's not easy on us to deal with it as parents because we're scared that it's going to happen again.
Robert Tootle and Tanisha Lindsay are the parents of 4-year-old Braden Tootle. They told us almost a year after the horrifying incident, they haven't gotten what they want the most. Answers about why this happened to their nonverbal autistic son.
It's a battle just because of the fact that nobody has reached out to us on any end. As far as just me and his mother.
The lawyer representing the family told me the lawsuit is necessary because the school district simply is not providing answers.
How long was he incompetent? Was he incompetent when they hired him? Should he never been hired to begin with? So those are questions that we have.
Attorney Michael Wright is not just referring to Derek Sorrell's job performance, but also the fact that after he was criminally charged in the incident, he was found not competent to stand trial. We reached out to Dayton Public Schools, who told us the employee was placed on leave that day and is no longer employed with Dayton Public Schools. The parents of the student involved were also communicated with the same day the incident occurred. Braylon Tootle's parents do not agree with that.
Just sad that, you know, they was trying to make themselves look better for the public versus trying to make amends with us, and we all seen the same video.
The lawsuit that was filed Tuesday is directed toward the school board, the school district, and the former DPS employee. Victoria Fonseca for Kaplan News.